La Sylphide has a rather straightforward plot. A boy who already has a girl meets an altogether different sort of girl and finds himself confronted with a provocative choice. It also appears to have a simple moral theme. Beware of trying to capture the unattainable. Discussing the meaning of La Sylphide strikes me as a bit like trying to express how my own voice sounds to me. This is the first ballet I can remember ever having seen. I danced in it when I was a 9-year-old student at the Royal Danish Ballet School. At the risk of exposing myself as a slow learner, I will tell you that it took me almost 20 years to graduate to the role of James, the male lead. But working my way up through the corps, I came to know this ballet very well. Whenever I look at the cozy domestic scene that provides the setting for Act One, it's as if I'm staring into my own living room. August Bournonville, the fountainhead of classical Danish choreography, saw the Paris Opera Ballet perform a dance in 1834 based on a Scottish folktale called La Sylphide. For 2 francs and some change, he bought a copy of the libretto and commissioned a score from Hermann von Löwenskiöld, who happens to be my mother's sister's husband's grandfather. 2 years later, the Royal Danish Ballet premiered Bournonville's own version. La Sylphide was the first romantic ballet. In the world of romance, the laws of nature are suspended. The ideal, the radiant, ethereal perfection that exists only in dreams reveals itself. The curtain is about to rise on James, who on his wedding day sees something in a dream. In the last 20 or so years, several offspring of the Royal Danish Ballet have staged their own visions of La Sylphide. In my staging, I chose not to add anything. I simply went back to the essential La Sylphide and said, this is the romantic ballet as I was brought up. I've paced it somewhat differently, speeded it up a bit, but there's virtually nothing of me in this. The most important point is that in Act One, James never laid a finger on the sylph. Because, well, what happens if you touch a sylph? Is she flesh and blood? If you touch a sylph, will the real world prevail? Thank you.
Thank you. funding for this program provided by the Pew Charitable Trusts.